Dalton wins this weekend, is the Adam Azim fight still on the cards for after?
I mean, we've been told by a boxer that Azim is not taking the fight, but they haven't pulled out the purse bid yet. I guess because they've got a fight week next week and because of Saturday night, that they'll pull out today or tomorrow because it sort of solves the questions. But if they don't, I just don't know what the play is. If Dalton wins on Saturday, we're looking at world level, not Adam Azim, but we'll 100% still take the fight because we're very confident we win it, and it's a big fight commercially. Still does a good gate, does good viewing figures, but they just, you know, the only way they might take that fight is if Dalton got beat or got dropped and scraped a decision on Saturday night. But if he wins in style, there is absolutely no way Adam Azim will fight.
Which fight are you looking forward to the most at the weekend?
Campbell Hatton against Jimmy Joffre.
It's going to be a scrap, isn't it?
Like, you know, and I've got to be honest, I'm really nervous for Campbell because imagine all that pressure where really, if he gets beat on Saturday night, obviously his career's not over, but the trajectory is completely different. You're losing for the Central Area title. He's 14-0. So you can't say he hasn't had the apprenticeship, he hasn't had the opportunity to learn. But sometimes you're not good enough. I actually think he's going to stop Jimmy Joffre. I think he's going to put a really great performance in. But there's such a huge amount of pressure because you're fighting the champion. He sold 300 tickets. He's going to have a load of support. You know that he's going to box out of his skin, Flint, because what a chance for him. And, you know, of course, Terry Harper against Andy Ryan as well. I'm really looking forward to that fight. And Ishmael Davis against Trot. I think it's a brilliant card, but... yeah, Campbell against Jimmy Joffre, I think it'd be a lot of fun.
And just finally from me, obviously you are a huge advocate for men's mental health. A lot of people are a bit concerned about Ryan Garcia at the minute, you know, with his drinking and putting it on social media and stuff like that. Do you think we need to kind of protect him of some sorts?
I think it's down to the people that really know him and know what's actually happening. I mean, from the outset, it looks very concerning. But, you know, Oscar says he's trolling. I mean, let's be honest, he's definitely not trolling. But only they know the truth. Like, his trainer. I mean, Derek James, I'm pretty confident, if Ryan Garcia wasn't 100% mentally and physically, the trainer should, and I would expect Derek James to, say, I'm out. Or he's not fighting. Same with Golden Boy, same with the family. So you'd hope that one of those three layers would do something about it if that was the case, but it might not be the case, and maybe he's turning up at the gym and he's fit, he's sparring well, and everyone's going you know. But certainly the behaviour, when someone's behaviour changes so much, should always be a concern.
As an outsider, would you be concerned?
I mean, I think a lot of people have got enough going on with their life to be concerned about people you don't know. I mean, but his behaviour is concerning, yeah, if it's true. And I don't see why it wouldn't be true. But again, you don't know what's happening in the gym. Like, just because he's going on Twitter and having a rant, if he's turning up, doing his sessions, sparring well, weight's good, looking sharp, you know, maybe Golden Boy or the family have spoke to Derek James and gone, how's he looking in the gym? And Derek's gone, actually really good. Then all of a sudden it kind of changes the dynamic a little bit. But yeah, it is. I think also, if you're an outsider, you're probably thinking the fight's not happening, you know? But all of a sudden, what are we now, 4 weeks out? So the closer it gets, the more chance there is of the fight happening, because they would have pulled him out by now. And what would be really annoying is if they pull him out a week before the fight, because Devin is seeing all this. He's training his heart out, and he's just got to take the leap of faith that the fight is happening. And if they pull him out a week to go, it makes you feel like they've tried to keep him in the fight, which is not a good look. Because you don't try and keep someone in a fight if there is a problem like that, you know?
Thank you.
Okay, so any more movement on this Queensby versus Matchroom?
Yeah, we've done it. I mean, we've done the filming for the weights, so now myself and George are going and finding our best fighter from those weight classes. And no one will know who they are until the press conference, which will be April, I believe April the 15th. I thought it was going to get announced last week, the weight classes, but it looks like it could be the end of this week. So, but everything's fine, the date, everything. And there will be an unveiling of the fighters at that press conference where no one will know actually who they are until that press conference.
Eddie, you spoke about Campbell Hatton earlier. If he is victorious at the weekend, where do you take Campbell? Is he going to go the traditional route, or are you looking to
Definitely tradition. And it, you know, this is a low-level tradition. It's an area title. Sometimes people talk about British, Commonwealth, European. We're talking about central area, English, British, Commonwealth, European. So I like it. You know, his dad won the central area title 25 years ago. It's a great story. And this is, to be honest with you, level-wise, this is exactly the level he should be starting at for championship level. Pure 50-50 fight, I think. And if he can't beat Jimmy Joe Flynn, he couldn't win an English title. And if he can't win an English title, he can't win a British title, and so on. So it doesn't mean that you can't do it in the future. But there's a lot of pressure on him on Saturday night. I actually think he's going to win by stoppage. I think he's going to box really well.
Do you think that having Ricky as a father is putting the extra pressure on?
Oh, horrendous. Like, I mean, don't get me wrong. Great to open a door, but horrific. Well, all you hear, I mean, how many press conferences have we heard, he's not his dad? Fucking hell, we get that. His dad was a legend and a very, very good fighter. And listen, maybe Campbell won't meet those levels, but he can still win a British title, European title. I mean, who knows how he's going to progress, but... And also, it makes you more of a target. You know that Jimmy Joe Flynn has trained twice as hard for this fight because he fancies it. They all fancy they can beat Campbell Hatton. But maybe it'll be different when they get in there.
A bit more news on Katie Taylor. We heard that she's now no longer boxing at the end of May, which I think is the proposed date. Is there any news on who she may be sort of fighting? Someone like Natasha Jonas has popped up in the last few days.
Yeah, she looks like she's going to fight in June now. We're finalising that. She could fight in America. It won't be Jonas. You know, there's been a couple of discussions with Amanda Serrano's team. I think the Katie is going to fight Amanda Serrano and Chantel Cameron this year. I truly believe that. I mean, there aren't outside of maybe the odd mandatory, they are the fights, and they must happen, and they will happen as well. So there is a chance that, you know, maybe it could be Serrano next. And if it's not in June, maybe it could be in September, October. But, you know, we need to nail that June date, and I expect that to be done next week.
Okay.
Yeah, let's see how you do under pressure.